A very warm welcome to all the students. In this lecture, we are going to see how PDA accepts a given string. Let us recapitulate. In the previous lecture, we have seen what is PDA, what are the components of PDA. Okay. In this lecture, we are going to deal with the further part. Okay. So, finite automata, as we have already seen in the first and second unit, they accept a string by moving to the final state at the end of the string. So we have seen that once the input string is read completely, that time we have to check where finite automata reaches, in which state. If that state happens to be one of the final states, then we can say the given input string is accepted by finite automata. It is said to be accepting a string in two ways. One, by moving to the final state at the end of the string, and by emptying the stack at the end of the string. Okay, the only difference, the main difference between the finite automata and PDA is that PDA, along with the components, okay, of finite automata, it has additional auxiliary memory, right? So a given string is said to be accepted by PDA in two ways. One, by moving to the final state at the end of reading the entire string, and second, by emptying the stack at the end of the string. We are shortly going to see an example wherein we are going to see how acceptance is achieved by PDA. Now, coming to the next concept, what are the different types of PDA? There are basically two types of PDAs. The first one is called as deterministic PDA or DPDA. It is similar to your DFAs and it makes only one move on reading an input symbol, just like your DFA. But the main difference between DPDA and DFA, apart from auxiliary memory, is that DFAs, we have seen already, they don't allow null transitions. DFAs, they don't allow null transitions. Whereas DPDAs, they allow null transitions. The second category is non-deterministic PDA or NPDA. These are pretty similar to NFAs and they make more than one move on reading the input symbol. We are going to deal with DPDAs first and then NPDAs, right? Now, before we move on to see an example to design a PDA, it is utmost essential that we know how transitions are written in PDA, okay? So, when I'm saying transition, it is actually, suppose I have one state, say Q0, and the second state is Q1. Transition means, what are you going to write on this transition line? Okay, this is the transition. Okay, now in case of finite automata, only the input string that was read, okay, only the input string that was read, only that was supposed to be present here. But in PDA, okay, since there is auxiliary memory component also, the transitions in PDA are different. So the transition in PDA is written as A, X/S, where what is A is the current input symbol read by the input pointer. Now your string that is given as input may be a long string, but for every transition, this A, the first component, will be the current symbol in that string which is being read, okay, by the input pointer A. X is nothing but, it is the topmost element in the stack, that is currently which element is the topmost element of the stack, so that is X, right? And S over here is the current string that is pushed into the stack as a result of push, pop or no operation. Okay, now this is a bit confusing. You might say that how can you push a string when you are dealing with pop operation or no operation? Of course, pushing involves in push operation, but how come it involves in pop as well as no operations? I had already discussed this in the previous lecture, but just to make it more clearer so that we can easily start with problem solving, let me give you an example. Okay, now how do we do this push operation? Suppose the current string that is, you know, given to me, or the string that is being read, is PQR, and the current input symbol that is being read is P. Okay, so what I want to do is, I want to push this P into the stack. So that's my push operation for current this. So the currently read input symbol, that is P, I want to push it onto the stack. Before that, let us analyze what is there in the stack. Stack is not empty because Z naught is not the topmost element. Stack contains topmost element as M. So there is one element already present in the stack, that is M. Now, if I want to push this P inside the stack, what I will have to do? The first thing, I will have to pop this M out. So I have to pop M out. So once M is popped out, the stack again turns out to be empty. You can notice that Z naught is the topmost element. Okay. Now, I have to concatenate this P, which is a currently read input symbol. I have to concatenate this P to the symbol that is just popped out. I have to concatenate P, which is the symbol that is currently read in the input string, to the symbol that is just popped out from the stack, which was earlier the topmost element of the stack. So when I concatenate this, the string will be PM. PM. Now I have to push this string PM in reverse order. Now this reverse order is because, you know, stack is first in, first out. So you can try this. When you push a string onto the stack, suppose the string is A, B, C, which you push into the stack. So A will be pushed first, B will be pushed next, C will be pushed next. When you are going to retrieve the string back, you are going to read it in the reverse order, because the element which is inserted first will be retrieved last, last in, first out structure. That's why while pushing into the stack, you have to be careful. Although you are pushing the string called as PM, you have to reverse it, make it MP and then push. Okay, make it MP and then push. So M will be inserted first and then on top of that P will be inserted. So if you compare the first and the last figure, it is now very easy to understand that my aim was to push P inside and now at the end P is on top of M, right? But on the way, the steps that we have considered are these steps. Okay, so now let us come back. I was actually, you know, discussing what is this S. We already know what is A. A is the current input symbol that is being read in the input string. X is the currently topmost element of the stack. What is this S? I just told you S is the current string that is being pushed into the stack as a result of push operation, pop operation or no operation. So what is this S? Now, in my case over here, you can see ultimately for this entire operation, what did I push? The string that I pushed was PM. So for push operation, this particular operation, S component, the string will be PM. Clear? So S here for my push operation for this case over here will be PM. Now let's see what will be the value of S for the pop operation. Okay, now let's see what's the pop operation. Now suppose this is the current stack. Stack contains M, one element, and I want to pop this M out. Now popping actually means what? You have to pop this M out, so M is no longer present in the stack. Stack turns out to be empty. And then, as we have already seen yesterday, after popping M out, I have to push null inside. This is a very important thing. So I have to push a null inside. Now, so when I push null inside, as you know, null means nothing. So ultimately, this actually means that there is nothing apart from Z naught. There is nothing on top of this thing. But what are you pushing? Which string are you pushing? That is null. So remember, whenever you are dealing with pop operation with respect to PDA, always the element that you are going to push into the stack after popping this element out will be always null. So now for pop operation, S will be null. Because what is S? S is nothing but the current string that is pushed into the stack. For this pop operation, what is being pushed into the stack? It is null. So S is null for this pop operation. Now, what is the value of S for no operation? Let's see. Now, when I say no operation, it simply means that M was already on top of the stack, and after the operation also, M will be on top of the stack. Now, to achieve this, what we do? First thing, I pop this M out. So when M is popped out, the stack turns out to be empty. And then after popping this M out, I have to put it back into the stack. I have to push it back into the stack, right? So you again push M back into the stack so that you now compare the initial and the final stack. M, which was already on top of the stack, after the operation M is still on the top of the stack. But how did you achieve this? It was the intermediate process that we saw here. Okay, so again when I ask you the question, for this no operation, what is that element which was pushed? M was pushed inside. So for no operation, S is M. Okay, now having done this basics, let us quickly start solving an example. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to solve an example. Let's say we have to design a PDA for the following language, L equal to A raised to N, B raised to N, such that N is greater than 0. That you're going to do. Okay. When you analyze, you will see two things. First thing, okay, number of A's are equal to number of B's. Right? And of course, second very important thing is, null will not be, null does not belong to the language. Why? Because n is greater than 0. Correct? And third most important thing is the order of, so only after all the A's are exhausted, only then B's will start. So, order of A's and B's. So, if I ask you, okay, how will you solve this problem? Okay, you should always first try to think manually how you would have solved this problem if you were given something like stack. Okay, so let's consider a minimum possible string. Consider a valid string. You can take any valid string. I will consider, say, 3 A's and 3 B's. Okay, let's consider any valid string, say 3 A's and 3 B's. Okay, now initially, this is the stack of PDA. Initially, the stack is empty. So, as you know, token Z0 will be always on top of the stack. And this is the input string that is given as input to the PDA. And A is the current input symbol which is being read. Okay, and let's assume that initially the PDA is in Q0 state, which is an idle state. PDA is in a Q0 state. Now, always before drawing PDAs, the very first thing what you need to do is you need to think manually how you would have solved the problem if you were given something like a stack. Now you see that number of A's here should be equal to number of B's, which simply means for every A there should be a matching B. So what I will do, manually I would have done this. No matter how many A's I encountered, as long as I get A, I will keep on pushing A's onto the stack. For example, when the first A is encountered here, okay, what I will do? I will push that A onto the stack. First A is pushed onto the stack, right? After pushing A onto the stack, okay, machine moves to maybe from Q0, it moves to say Q1 state. Okay, and next element is also A. Then another A is encountered. So that A also I am going to push onto the stack on top of the previous element. Okay, correct? So then the pointer moves to the next A. The pointer moves to the next element and that is also A. So another A is encountered. I am going to push that A also on top of the stack. So all the three A's encountered, I simply went on pushing onto the stack, right? Now, after pushing the third A, when the pointer increments to the next element, when you are in Q1 state, it's a state wherein you just go on pushing. No matter how many A's are encountered, maybe hundreds of A's, you will just go on pushing all the A's onto the stack and you will, since you will be repeating the same operation, you will be always staying in that same state, Q1. Now, when you are in Q1 state and when the first B is encountered, now you have to do something different. What you will have to do, the B that you have encountered, this B, you will have to compare with the element on the stack. If for this B, for the current B, if there is a matching A, okay, then you have to cancel out this B and this A. And cancelling out means what? You literally don't have to cancel out. It simply means that this A will be popped out of the stack and the pointer will be just incremented to the next element. So as good as saying that B is cancelled out with A. Okay. And since you are going to do comparing and matching from Q1 state, I will have to move to a different state. Let's do it and see. So I am in Q1 state. When the first B is encountered in Q1 state, what you do? You check what is there on top of the stack. If there is a matching A encountered, then what you do? You simply pop that A out. Okay, you simply pop that A out. Okay, and the pointer now moves to the next B. So it is as good as saying that that A which I popped out got cancelled with this B. Okay, next. So after doing this, I will be changing the state. I am in Q2 state. So Q2 will be a state wherein the machine will do a task of matching, comparing and cancelling, right? So now, no matter how many more B's are encountered on the way, machine is going to do the same activity of comparing, matching and cancelling. So no matter how many more B's are encountered, I will always remain in now Q2 state, now onwards. Okay, now B is encountered. Okay, the current next element encountered is B. Okay, we check on top of the stack there is a matching A. So what I'll do, I'll cancel out this B with this A. It simply means A will be popped out of the stack to reveal the last A, and the input pointer will be moved to the next element, that is, and you will remain in the same state Q2. Why? Because you have done the same operation of comparing and matching. Now again, when you are in Q2 state, if B is encountered, again when you are in Q2 state, if B is encountered at the next element, do the same thing. You check who is there on top of the stack. If there is a matching A, you cancel out this B with this A, and cancelling out, it simply means popping the A out, popping this A out, and moving the pointer one position to the left, right? So, and you still remain in Q2 because you have just done the same operation, okay, of comparing and matching. Now please see what has happened. Your entire input is already read. There is nothing else remaining to be read. So whenever there is nothing else remaining to be read, what is read? Null is read. Okay, so when you are in Q2 state, when null is read as input, that means when there is nothing read as input, that time you check the stack. If stack is also empty, so what is the meaning of stack empty? Z0 should be topmost element of the stack. So in Q2 state, when there is nothing else remaining to be read, that means when null is read as input, and when stack top is Z0, that means there is nothing else remaining in the stack, that time what you do? Do nothing. There is no other operation that you can do. Do nothing. And from Q2 state, which was non-final state, you just move to the final state, that is Q3. Yes? So it's a simple method. So whatever I said, I'll now do the same thing, okay, using a PDA, designing a PDA. Okay? So initially I was in which state? I was in Q1 state. Right? I was in Q0 state. And the input pointer initially was not reading anything, or it was just positioned at the first element. Okay, so same thing I'm going to do diagrammatically now. Okay, let's assume that Q0 is the initial state. In this initial state, okay, in Q0, initially what is the thing? The input is not yet read, nothing is read yet. Pointer is just positioned to the first element of the input string, and the stack is empty, so Z0 is on top of the stack. Now, in this Q0 state, what happens? When the first A is encountered, what you have done? You have simply pushed this A onto the stack. When the first A is encountered, what you do? You have pushed this A onto the stack, and from Q0 you have moved to Q1 state. Right? So, when you are in Q0 state, I am just going to write this. When you are in Q0 state, please notice how I am writing the transition. When A is read as input symbol, and at that time, if Z0 is on top of the stack, then what you do? I push A onto the stack. Now please notice, when you are going to push A onto the stack, what is that S? I have just spoken about S, right? See, A is the current input symbol that is read from the input string. X is the topmost element of the stack. And what is S? S is the current string that is being pushed onto the stack. Now here I am saying, I'll be pushing A into the stack. But is it A only that I'll be pushing onto the stack? No, I will have to remove Z naught out. And then I will have to concatenate A with Z naught, so that the string that will be formed will be A Z naught. And then that A Z naught string, of course in a reverse way, I will have to insert it into the stack, right? So what operations are you going to perform now onto the stack? Pushing A, right? So what exactly you are doing? Pushing what string? A Z naught. Correct? And you will go to Q1 state. So what exactly you have done? This A you are now pushing onto the stack. So A is now here. Okay? And the input pointer now points to the next A. And you are from Q0 state, you have moved to Q1 state. Agreed? Okay? So one A you have already inserted onto the stack, correct? So what we have done, when A is the input symbol in Q0 state, when A is read as the input symbol, you have checked what is there on top of the stack. Stack was empty, that means Z0 was on top of the stack. So what you did, you pushed A inside the stack. So for pushing A, you removed Z0, the string was concatenated to form AZ0, and that AZ0 together, the string was pushed onto the stack. So after slash, what you write is, what string have you pushed? So it is AZ0. Fine. You are in Q1 state. Now in Q1 state, what you do? From idle state, you have moved to a working state. Q1 is the state wherein I will be just going on pushing the A's. No matter how many A's are encountered, I will be just going on pushing the A's onto the stack. Okay, so now in Q0, in Q1 state, now what do you observe? Another A is encountered. That time you check who is there on top of the stack. Why do you check? Because if there is a B, then matching will have to be done, right? Of course, that string won't be valid. B cannot be in the stack. So when you are in Q1 state, if A is encountered as the input symbol, that time if another A is already present on top of the stack, okay, then this A also you will have to push onto the stack, correct? So how can you push this A onto the stack? First you will remove this A out, concatenate this A with that A to form string AA, and it is this string AA that will be pushed inside. Okay, so in Q1 state, what you are doing, and you are going to repeat this, right? So it's a repetition. In Q1 state, what you are going to do, if A is encountered as the next element in the input string, that time you check the stack, and in the stack, if A is also the topmost element of the stack, like what has happened here, okay, A and A, what you do, you remove this A out, you concatenate this A with that A to form string AA, and it is that A string which is pushed. So after slash, what do you write? What is the element that is pushed? What you push is AA. Agreed? And by doing that, you will stay in the same state, Q1. So let's do that. So what will happen? A, I am pushing it into the stack. So A is now here. And the input pointer now points to the next element, assuming that the previous element is already read, or it's already gone onto the stack. Now again you are in Q1 state. Again you are in Q1 state. Right? And again the input that is read now is A. And the top of the stack is also A. So what, now you know what to do. If A is read as input, current input symbol, and on top of the stack is also another A, then what you do? You push A. So when you push A inside, again it will be AA string that will be pushed. You will have to remove this A out, concatenate it with this A to form AA, and that AA string you will have to push inside. Okay, so very important, many a time students have misconception. What do you write here after slash? It is not the current content of the stack. It is what string you are pushing currently. and not the current entire content of the string. Okay, remember this. So A is read as current input symbol, stack also contains A, then what you do, you push this A inside. So what do you push is A, and you remain in Q1. So no matter how many more A's are encountered, you're going to do this. So at the end of this operation, your input pointer, it will be incremented. Your input pointer will be incremented, and that A will be added here, right? And you will remain in the same Q1 state. Now, so no matter how many more A's are encountered, you're always going to do the same operation, pushing, pushing, pushing. Just the moment you get A's, you just go on pushing. Now, when you are in Q1 state and when the first B is encountered, you are no longer going to push. You are going to do a different operation, that is comparing and matching, right? And cancelling. So when you are in Q1 state, when the first B is encountered as input, I will just write in Q1 state. Okay? In Q1 state. In Q1 state, when the first B is encountered as the input symbol, when B is encountered as the input symbol, and that time suppose stack contains A, that means for that B you have a matching A. So then what you do? You cancel out this B with this A, and cancelling out means what? It simply means that this A will be removed, popped out of the stack, and the input pointer will point to the next element B. As good as saying that this B is cancelled out with that A. Okay, so now, as we have already discussed, okay, for pop operation, what should be S? See, whenever you pop any element, what do you push in turn? You are going to push null inside. So S value will be null. Correct? So that's why here what I have done, if B is the current input symbol and if stack contains A on top of it, B and A gets cancelled, that means A is popped out of the stack. What you are going to write here, what is pushed at the end of pop operation? So what is pushed? Null. So the element that you are going to write here is null. And you are going to a new state called as Q2. You cannot remain in Q1 because Q1 state you are doing a different task, pushing, pushing and pushing. Whereas now you have changed the task. You have compared and you have cancelled. Okay, popped element out. Okay. So at the end of this, okay, you will be going to which state? You will be going to Q2 state. Now, in Q2 state, any more number of ways which are encountered, no, you are going to repeat the same operation. Okay, so in Q2 state, if there is another B that is encountered as the input symbol, okay, if there is another B that is encountered as the input symbol, at that time, suppose stack also contains a matching A, okay, B comma A, then what you do? You are going to cancel out this B with this A. As good as saying that A will be popped out of the stack. And popping something out means pushing what? Pushing null inside. So null will be pushed inside and you will remain in the same state Q2. Why you are going to remain in the same state Q2? Because you have performed the same operation. Okay. So pointer will increment to the next B, as good as saying that the previous B is deleted. And you are in the same state Q2. Again, in the state Q2, if the input string is B and the stack contains matching A, then again this B will cancel out with this A. Okay, that means the A will be popped out of the stack. A will be popped out of the stack, and what will be pushed inside the stack? None. So that's why this null. A will be popped out of the stack, and the input pointer will be incremented to the next element, as good as saying that the previous element is deleted. Now you are in Q2 state. Observe, is there anything remaining to be read in the input string? You see, entire input string is exhausted, right? So when the entire input string is exhausted, okay, you should see whether you have reached the end of the string. Sorry, you should see whether the stack is also empty. So what I will do, I will just say when in Q2 state, very important step, please note, in Q2 state, when there is nothing else remaining to be read, that means when null is read, and at that time stack is also empty, that is Z0. So when there is nothing else remaining to be read, at that same time you check the stack. Stack is also empty. This means that the given string is accepted. Then you have to go to the final state. So if there is nothing else remaining to be read in the input string, that time stack also happens to be empty, that means your string is accepted. And then that means also from Q2 state you are supposed to go to Q3 state, which is the final state. Okay, but the question remains is, what should I write here? Now see, there is nothing remaining to be read, stack is also empty. So are you going to perform any operations on the stack? Are you going to push something? Are you going to pop something? No, it's a no operation, no change operation, right? So we have already discussed, even if it is no operation, that means if M was on top of the stack, at the end M itself will be on top of the stack. But in this process, what are you pushing? You are pushing M inside. You are popping M out and again pushing M back. Now who is there on top of the stack? Z0 is there on the top of the stack. So if you want to perform a no operation on the stack, okay, what you will have to do? You will have to remove Z0 out, pop Z0 out, and again push Z0 back. So what is that which you are pushing back? It is Z0. So what are you going to write? You are going to write Z0 here. And always read this like, you should always read it like this. When there is nothing remaining to be read, Z0 is on top of the stack, you have performed no operation, Z0 still remains on top of the stack, and you go to the final state. So what we have drawn here happens to be the push down automata for the given language. Okay. One small thing which I want to focus on before I end this topic. If for the language, if it was given a raised to n, b raised to n, where n is greater than or equal to 0, then null could have become part of the string. Okay, that means null string also could have been accepted. So in such cases, if it is n greater than or equal to 0, then you can easily make out the initial state also would have become the final state. So you would have two final states in the automata. One will be the Q3 state, and Q0 also will be the final state. That's the only difference. Okay? Thank you.